Hey gamers, welcome back to another rant by me. My name is Matt Jarbo. I run twistedjoystick.com. This is my channel, YouTube, Mr. Game Bro. Check out my videos. They're pretty fucking awesome. I like to say so myself. Or if I do say so myself, and I do. Anyway, so you looked at the title of this video and you're like, what the hell? So yeah, I think that gaming journal. This is a video about why mainstream gaming journalism is really bad for the industry. And I think just in gaming in general, and why I think that really you should focus more of your attention on smaller sites than the others. Now, I know that a lot of you diehard IGN fanboys out there, or GameSpot fanboys, or Team Xbox, or things of that nature, you guys are probably going to go like, well, you're kind of full of shit and whatever. But no, I'm going to tell you guys why. Now, let's just start with my experience, because I don't like, you know, I want to tell you guys about me and what I've done over the years, and that way it gives you guys an idea of where I'm coming from on this one. So I've been doing gaming journalism, quote unquote journalism, off and on since 2000. I worked at a small website called SSPIN, so people thought it was spin, but no, it's not. It's spin, right? And it was meant to be a small gaming journalism review site from some guys I'd met who lived in Olympia, Washington. At the time, I lived in San Diego. And so we worked together on a few projects. They sent me to E3 a couple years. Yes, I've gone to E3 2000, 2001, 2003, 04, 05, 06, 09, and 10. So I would have gone this year, but they literally denied me at the door, stating that I didn't have enough credentials, which was bullshit. That's not what this is about. And then, but the point is, I worked with SSPIN.com. And then my friend Adam, who I met through filmmaking, he opened up GameDreams.com, which is supposed to be a gamer news, reviews, and rumor mill website. So we had that up and running in 03, and that ran till about 07, around 08. So about 5 years that site was up. So I did work with them. And so then I did a podcast for a year on GameDreams with my friend Hedgehog. And so I've been around. I've done a lot of small projects. I've worked with AskAJedi.com. In fact, I'm working with AskAJedi.com again next week for Comic-Con. But the point is I've been around for a decade, you know, now more so than a decade. I know a thing or two about this kind of stuff. So when I say that, like, major gaming journalism sucks, and if you go back and look through the years of IGN, and I'll use IGN as an example. I remember IGN in the 90s, right? They were small, they're, you know, internet gaming news, and it was just like, it was just giving you information on games and stuff, and then it built and built and built because it kept sinking so much money into it. I just found this out recently that it's owned by News Corp, so they're going to put a ton of money into it regardless. And so if you think about it, it became this gigantic corporate entity, and as a result has become, you know, the largest entertainment news website on the web. They can post anything and they get millions and millions of hits and traffic a day because they've somewhat edged out the competition. Now, IGN has been known. IGN is one of those, it's like a game of Katamari Damacy, right? IGN will go in and just pick up other websites. They just bought 1UP.com. They purchased TeamXbox.com a couple years ago. Independent sites that, well, not 1UP wasn't independent, but they pick up independent websites and then they assimilate them into the IGN family, gaining their traffic and gaining more control while still increasing their revenue. And they have deals worked out with all the major developers, because the major developers want to have, you know, interviews with them because they get the traffic, and therefore that's how the system works. And that's fine, because that's general marketing, you know, news bullshit, really, is that's how it works, is it just flows like that. So now let's look at how things are today. Now I'm going to take, if you look at something like GameInformer.com or IGN or Destructoid or, Joystick or Kotaku and any of those major sites that report on the news. And you'll see that they all do the same thing. Oh, Eurogamer, VG, 247. Hell, Reddit Gaming, or really, you know. So the idea is this. Okay. And I do this too. I want you guys, when this is over or right now, to go click over to twistedjoystick.com. And you'll see on my site that I pretty much follow the exact same format as these guys do. Now, but I make no assumption about what I do. Okay. I run a site. It's a small thing. I don't have as much time in the day as I would like to hunt down all the information and post it. So I generally just post links to the actual news story, provide my commentary, give a little bit of extra information if necessary, say the word fuck, whatever, try to be funny, and move on with my day. That's kind of what I do. I give tidbits of information, linking you over to their stuff. I'm like a hub site. But that is exactly what they do. If you look at any one of those sites, you will always see source cited at the bottom, and it goes to another website. So what do? They all read each other's shit, and then they repost each other's shit, but they link back to each other, so it's creating backlinks, which is increasing their Google page rank, right? Which is increasing the amount of traffic to their website, which therefore increases the amount of ad revenue they receive, right? Based on all their, or they can charge. So the stuff they can charge, you know, their advertisers to put on their website and stuff like that. So it's one gigantic incestuous clusterfuck, right? It almost feels like no one really reports the news. They just regurgitate what somebody else said. Now, the general, you know, and the companies do this too. The companies are okay with this. They don't mind. You know, I'll see something like, you know, something on Joystick, and goes like, oh, our friends over at Destructoid, they discovered this, and so blah, 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 blah. We sent off a comment, we asked for comment from this website, but they haven't got back to us yet, but here's the story anyway. So they do that, and then as a result, their readers, who are like, oh, wow, cool, man, these guys are really on the ball on shit. It was Destructoid who did the legwork. They maybe sent an email or lied their ass off about it. I got no fucking idea, but they didn't get the information back, so they're really just regurgitating what somebody else said. Right now, the other thing I want to talk about is journalism is no longer fucking journalism. When you write a story, when you write an article, when I worked at Game Dreams and we wrote reviews, we had a formulated review structure, right? I would write like using size 10 font, 4-page reviews, like literally 4 pages of reviews breaking down games via category. Now I'm not going to lie. That shit was tedious as fuck for a long time. I'm like, man, damn it. Okay. What's this argument? Can I use this argument again? Blah, 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 blah. It got really fucking annoying real quick, but that's how we did it. And other websites did the same thing too. Now go look at the way IGN does its reviews. They do about 5 to 6, 3 to 4 sentence paragraphs per page. They generally do an overview of most of what the game is. They touch base on a few issues and then they move on. So the reviews are designed to be basically ingested like tweets. You read each paragraph as about a tweet because that's about how long they are. They're not meant to be any longer than that because people have a fucking very limited mindset. So they want to have these reviews because they're getting paid by these companies or getting review copies from these companies or favors from these companies to provide reviews for their games, and they have to do it, but they're going to work on it in a way that's, you know, not very long. It's more like blogging. So game journalism today is more like blogging than anything else. And that kind of like, it just go look at all the major sites and you'll see that. They kind of put a bleep out there or something and that's it. They just do a little bit of thing and that moves on with it. So, and that, you know, that, and that, that said, but it's just kind of, I think the way attention spans are nowadays, people get like that. So back to my next topic, and probably my final topic on this, because I've been ranting for too long, is that the journalists that are on these websites, a good solid majority of them are fake gamers. They are. If you listen to IGN's PlayStation podcast, those guys repeatedly say that they are not video game writers. They are writers that are hired to write about video games. And I have heard more than them talk about this. So the people that you trust to provide the news and solid, unbiased reviews of titles are basically saying, no, we went to college for journalism. This is where I ended up working. I'll do it. It's not what I want. So their passion for the industry, for the entertainment, or, you know, for the video game world and for the dedication to their fan base is not there. They're shams. So they're paid and pretty solid, you know, pretty decent cash, a livable wage at least, to write about things they don't care about. So therefore you're not getting the full benefit of their ability, right? Their passion isn't there. So, but if you go to smaller websites, you'll find the passion and you'll find that general love of gaming. Now, you want to stick with those guys more than anyone else, in my opinion, because those guys are the ones that will give you the best quality and the best, the most passion towards the industry as a whole, and you'll get that. But they're gradually being shut down and shut out as these bigger guys are taking over more and more. So that's why you need to give smaller independent websites their support. I'm not saying go to Twisted Joystick and check that shit out. I mean, I'm going like thegamefanatics.com, wethegamers.com, gamefreakblog.com, things like that. Smaller websites that are dedicated. Go on Twitter and talk to some of those cats. They're fucking amazing, right? And they're great guys. So that's what I say. I'd say check them out. Don't listen to IGN because those guys are just in it for the money. The guys who do it for fun are the ones you really want to listen to because they're the ones that are dedicated, they're passionate, and they really love what they do. And that's what this rant's really about. Most mainstream gaming journalism is just shitty nowadays anyway. The fact that they got I Just Teen on game trailers just pretty much kills all credibility any of them fucking have. And Mega 64 sucks too. I just wanted to say that. All right, this is Jarbo. See you guys later.